and gentlemen, the golden voice, the Michigan Sports Hall of Famer, the broadcaster for your Detroit Pistons, Mr. George Blaha.
Thank you, John Mason. Good evening to our loyal Piston fans here at the Palace and Piston fans everywhere. It's exciting for me, believe me, to be part of a ceremony honoring one of the greatest clutch players to ever wear a Piston uniform. The incredibly talented, immensely popular Chauncey Billups. Chauncey's a five-time All-Star, two-time member of the All-Defensive Team. But what I don't want you to ever, ever, ever forget, he was the MVP of the 2004 NBA Finals when the Pistons brought down the Lakers in what will forever be called around here that five-game sweep. And you talk about big shots, we all remember the game changers and the game winners. And who could ever forget that half-court playoff bomb against the Nets? He was officially crowned then with his forever nickname, Mr. Big Shot. You know, no matter what his team needed, whether it was a big stop, a big pass, or a big shot, Chauncey delivered. And Chauncey has earned this honor tonight. Couldn't happen to a more deserving guy. Congratulations, Chauncey, to you and your family. As we prepare to send number one up to the rafters with the numbers of the other all-time Piston greats, let's meet our honored guest for this momentous occasion. First, Chauncey's family. His wife, Piper. Daughters, Sydney, Sierra, and Sanaya. Let's hear it for the Billups family. Now, Chauncey's Piston family. Piston owner, Tom Goris. And representing former Piston owner William Davidson, his son Ethan Davidson. Our vice chairman, Arne Tellem. And our president and CEO, Dennis Mannion. Also, longtime athletic trainer, Mike Abdenauer. Longtime team physician, Dr. Ben Pellucci. And former basketball executive Scott Perry and George David. Our Piston legends here tonight, the Twirl, Earl Cureton, Special K, Gregory Kelzer, Bad Boy, Rick Mahorn, the Mighty Microwave, Vinnie Johnson. One of the game's all-time greats, Dave Bing. And one of the very best to play anywhere, anytime in the NBA, the one and only Isaiah Thomas. Welcome home, Zeke. Chauncey's teammates are here, Mehmet Okur. Lindsey Hunter. The Palace Prince, Tayshaun Prince. Chauncey's all-star backcourt mate, Rip Hamilton. A versatile big man who could score both inside and out. Welcome back, Dice Antonio McDyke. And Wallace times two, our man Sheed, Rasheed Wallace. And Big Ben, Ben Wallace. Our first speaker, fans, is one of the all-time best at moving without the ball. In fact, he was always on the move. The king of the mid-range game and the Pistons' all-time leading postseason scorer, Rip Hamilton.
Wow. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Chauncey, they're only going to give me a minute to speak, but I can talk all day about you. You're like a brother to me. You're like a brother to the guys. We appreciate you. We love you. You had the hardest job on the court. You had to manage us five guys on the floor. You had to make sure Ben Wallace got the ball the first two plays of every game because we had to make him feel like he was a scorer. So you had to manage that. But also, I mean, every time I came off the screen, every time I was running around like a wild animal, you would put that ball right in a position for me to score. And you made my job easier. I don't know where my career would have been without you, but I can remember us laying right at the center court before every game, and we would get stretched by Arnie. And we would always look up, and we would say, our goal is to do what Isaiah and Joe and them did, and that's bring a championship here to Detroit Pistons. So, every time we threw that jersey on, the one thing that me and you used to always say, we gotta make Joe and Isaiah proud of us, because they were in the backcourt before us, and we're in the backcourt now trying to bring a championship here to Detroit. But my finest memories of you is, man, you could have came out each and every night and averaged over 20 points a game. But what you did, you sacrificed your own game to make sure that all of us was involved in the game. But when we needed you most, in that Los Angeles Lakers, in that series right there, boy, oh boy, boy, oh boy. I mean, you came out and you took totally control when you had one of the best defenders, Gary Payton, guarding you, play after play down the court. And you came up to me and says, hey, Rip, he can't hold me. I'm gonna go in and do what I gotta do and bring this championship home. So I read a quote on Instagram, because everybody's on Instagram these days. And the quote said, Chauncey, your front windshield is bigger than your rear view mirrors. What you did in the past, which was great, what's ahead of you is going to be a lot better than what you proved and you did on the basketball court. And I don't know what it is. It might be a GM, a president of a team, ownership of something. But my kids asked me the other day, they said, Dad, what's the definition of a role model? I pulled your picture up and showed them you. You are a role model. You're a role model to my boys. You're a role model to us. I love you and congratulations.